Well, good morning, everyone. As Stevens, president of the Fremont Flight, and I have a tendency to be involved in a lot of things in the La Crosse area, but none more important, more fun, or more rewarding than the Freedom Honor Flight. The whole Freedom Honor Flight started out with one gentleman, one idea, from a gentleman that was a physical therapist in Ohio. And he worked at a veterans hospital at that time, and he was dealing with one of the World War II veterans and helping him with his physical exercises. And the World War II monument had just opened in Washington, D.C. at that time. And this individual said, boy, it sure would be nice if I'd be able to see that before I die. And this gentleman had a private plane, and within a few days flew that one single World War II veteran to Washington, D.C. so he could see the World War II monument. Well, when he got back and others heard about it, the next flight they did was the entire air group from his hangar. They all got together and flew about 30 veterans out to Washington, D.C. And the feedback on that was so positive that we said, well, this should go nationwide. They're often referred to as the greatest generation because of the sacrifices that they did make. World War II, we lost over 400,000 American soldiers, a huge amount, and twice that many that were wounded at that time as well. But I can say that when this got going and we got the word of what was going to happen, La Crosse, Wisconsin, our house out of La Crosse, was the very first one in the state of Wisconsin. We're very proud of that. And now there are four others in Wausau, Milwaukee, Green Bay, and Madison. So it's catching on. At any rate, there are a couple that had started and folded. They just wanted to take World War II veterans and then stop at that time. We like them to continue to take care of them. So we have two flights going this year, one coming up on May 6th, and one coming up in the fall on September 16th. That will be our 19th and 20th flight that we've taken out of the La Crosse area, which makes about 1,800 veterans that we've already flown. Your check and other gifts that we get from fundraising and so on, each one of those flights costs about $100,000. It is a private jet that we take from La Crosse to Washington, D.C. By the way, when we leave La Crosse in the morning, it takes 75 minutes to get to Reagan Airport. I'm guessing that the high school group wishing only took 75 minutes to get to D.C. on the long bus trip this morning as well. We do have priorities. We still take our World War II veterans, we take our Korean veterans and our Vietnam veterans, then any and all veterans can apply and be part of it after that. So on this next flight that we have 9 World War II veterans going on May 6th, 78 Korean veterans, and then a few from Vietnam because of physical arrangements that they're going to come with us this time as well. I just wanted to mention one last thing here is that I do have, and I'll leave this with the librarian, I think, some actual applications. If anybody in your family is a vet, or you know somebody from the family that would like to go, this is where it all starts, by filling one of those out, or if you want to be a guardian. Then I have 3 books that I'm going to leave with you today. We can put them in the library, and hopefully you'll be able to take a look at them at that point. One is all about the Korean War Monument that's out in Washington, D.C. Forgotten No More is called. It's a great story about the Korean War and all the sacrifices that were made by those that participated as well. And we have one called The Jewel of All, and that's the whole story of the construction and history behind the development of the World War II monument, which I said was not dedicated to 2004. So when World War II ended in 1945, you can see it took them a long time to get around to get this done. And the last one, just so you have a sample of it here, is every veteran that goes on one of our flights, about 6 weeks after that flight, we have a reunion of that entire group, and they all get together, and we give them a hardbound book, which is full of photographs that were taken that day of their particular flight and their particular itinerary. So it works out very well to give them all that memorial. We also give them a CD at that time, done as well. So let me just end by saying, thank you, thank you, thank you. Any of these fundraisers that you can help us with are deeply appreciated. As I said, we're going to continue to keep the Freedom Honor Flight going as long as the community will support it. Our radius is about 120 miles from La Crosse, be in this area and parts of Minnesota and Iowa, and just a little bit past Eau Claire as well. So there are lots of veterans that deserve this honor. Most of them, when they came back from their service obligation, had no welcome home, nothing fancy at all. So we can do that for the Freedom Honor Flight and reward and thank them for the sacrifices they made for the country. We like to do that. So thank you so much for Viroqua Middle School.